most water-resistant Bluetooth earbuds? Is it the AirPods?
Is it the Powerbeats or the Galaxy Buds? That's why we're here to do some of my favorite tests, Lexi. Water tests. We're going to put them through a series of tests to see which one survives. First things first, none of these earbuds claim to be completely waterproof. The ones with the highest ratings are the Powerbeats Pro with an IPX4, which means they're sweat and water resistant.
Then there's the Galaxy Buds, which are rated IPX2. Again, that means some water and sweat resistance. And then we have the AirPods, which have zero water resistance listed, no IP rating. We have no idea how they perform against sweat, so this is gonna be really interesting.
Now, we're obviously gonna start with the claim for these two and then just work our way up, but suffice to say,
don't try this at home?
No.
Let's start with our sweat test with the Powerbeats Pro.
Let's make it a little more intense. Work up a sweat over here, Alexi. And then, since we don't have time to wait for you to work up a sweat, I get the fun job of spraying you in the face to simulate some sweat. Look at that. She's sweating. Okay, my workout. My very sweaty workout is complete. Now we're switching it up with the Galaxy Buds. I'm doing some intense strength training, Lexi. 40 reps.
Revenge is sweet.
Ta-da! Time to test out the AirPods. Workout on the bike.
Oh, no. Sweaty. Now that we're sufficiently soaked, well, you're sufficiently soaked.
Me.
We're gonna do exactly what the companies say we should do after you've exposed them to water, which is dry them off immediately.
Then we're gonna make sure that they can still connect to the phone, play some audio, see how it sounds, and record voice and see how that sounds. I'm gonna go into Bluetooth settings. Yes, they're connected. Yep, I can hear music in both.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. This is the Powerbeats.
Okay, Galaxy Buds time. Bluetooth, yes. Connect it. All right, let's play some music. They sound fine. It's a good song. I like the song.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. This is the Galaxy Buds.
Here we go. AirPods. Okay, heard the connection noise. It's fine. Music's playing.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. This is the AirPods.
Honestly, I was expecting these guys to survive this test.
All right, so it's time to up the ante.
On your marks, get set, go.
Powerbeats sunk straight to the bottom.
Fish them out.
All right. Oh. Drop.
Drop.
Okay, oh, some little bubbles coming up. Nice. And
I'm scared for these.
Me too. Am I supposed to take
them out? Oh, yes, stop.
I thought we were going
too
long. No, oh no. All right, let's leave them to air dry and then test them out.
Testing the music. Sound great.
Testing, testing, testing the Powerbeats.
I heard the sound. Connected.
Jam it out.
Testing, testing, these are the Galaxy Buds, 1, 2, 3.
Oh, I heard it.
You heard the noise?
I heard the noise.
Sound okay.
Testing, testing, these are the AirPods, 1, 2, 3.
So they all survived. I mean, I'm genuinely surprised. Even though they were only in for 5 seconds, I thought maybe it might have been enough to kill one of them.
At least the AirPods, as you saw, I was pretty shocked that we had dropped them in the first place. And then we went a little bit over with the AirPods. So they've already proven to go above and beyond. So, I mean, we have no other choice but just to raise the stakes over here.
Let's get extreme with our real-world testing. Laundromat time.
Yes!
We didn't want to fry any of the earbuds by putting them in the dryer, so they're coming straight from the washing machine.
The Powerbeats. Here they are. Ta-da! Lexi, you ready for them?
Not much moisture on them that I can see.
Connection.
They sound good!
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Powerbeats Pro.
Okay, it kind of had a little bit of a cutout, but the microphone is still working.
Get ready. They're all yours. They
seem pretty dry, surprisingly. That spin cycle must be pretty powerful. If I can't even, there's not even like a water droplet in here.
Right side.
I'm not hearing anything yet. Okay, connected, perfect. This one is totally out. And this one you can faintly hear it, and I have the volume cranked up to the absolute highest. So this is not going well for the Galaxy Buds. Testing the microphone on the Galaxy Buds. Testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing the microphone on the Galaxy Buds. Testing, 1, 2, 3. Sounds pretty clear. The earbuds, not so much. So we're gonna give them about 48 hours to fully dry off and do this test again. Here they are.
Well, they feel pretty dry. Let's put them in and see. I heard something. I heard something. I heard the connection noise. Okay, it sounded a little bit faint. Hey, wow. I was not expecting that. They don't sound great, and the left one definitely does not have as much volume as the right. Yeah, it's just distorted. The bass is a little crunchy and distorted. It just sounds like it's got a lot of water in it still. All right, let's do a voice recording and see what that sounds like.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3 AirPods.
Okay, so the microphone still works. Sounds a little muffled. Again, I'm really only hearing it on the right rather than on the left.
So, success, sort of. I mean, none of them survived 100%, but none of them died 100% either, so there's a silver lining.
There is, but in terms of usability, I mean, the Powerbeats were definitely the top.
Absolutely.
Then probably the AirPods, just because there was a little bit more volume, even though one of the earbuds didn't work. The Galaxy Buds, you really had to crank up that volume.
But the microphone was almost pristine out of all of them. So I think the only fair thing to do here is just to let them all dry out and see what happens in about 48 hours.
All right, we'll see you then. Vanessa, it's been 48 hours since we put these through the wash, so I think it's time to see if they've recovered any more and test them out.
Let's start with the Powerbeats. Go for it.
Alrighty, let's go.
Connected.
Music.
Despacito.
Despacito.
They sound good.
Testing the Powerbeats Pro 48 hours after washing.
I think the drying out really helped.
And now for the Galaxy Buds. These guys did not do so well last time.
They paired.
It's got a little bit of the volume back.
And only the right earbud works, and it sounds tinny.
Testing, 1, 2, 3. These are the Galaxy Buds.
They sound good.
48 hours after being dunked.
They half survived, but if you want to listen to music, you only got one earbud, so.
AirPods time.
Verify that it's connected, okay. Music time.
It just doesn't sound as clear, but they still work. They just don't sound like the original AirPods.
Yeah.
Testing, 1, 2, 3, AirPods 48 hours after being in the washing machine.
So they sound okay, but there's a bit of a crackle there.
Suffice to say, we have enough information to declare a winner, and it's obviously the Powerbeats. And that was kind of to be expected because they are the highest rated. However, they were not rated to withstand a washing machine. So kudos to the Powerbeats for still sounding great after going through the wash. Now, it gets kind of iffy after that because they all technically work to some degree. The Galaxy Buds did survive what they were rated for, except now you just have one ear.
Right, and I don't know about you, but using one ear is not my ideal use case.
At least
not. With the AirPods, you have two of them as usable. The microphone doesn't sound as good, but it still works. And the music is a little bit muddy, but again, it's still okay. It's not great, but it's passable. So I think all up, I think the AirPods did a little bit better in that respect because both of them were still working. Okay, so if you want to see how these buds compare in the dry world without any water, check out our comparisons of the Powerbeats, the AirPods, and the Galaxy Buds in our Versus series. Just gonna rock out a little bit.
Yeah.
They sound great. Oh! You definitely...
I'm sorry.
Why did you do that?